Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Good evening and welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host, and happy Valentine's Day. And since it is Valentine's Day, I decided to have two real cute little breeds for you. Of course, here on the table, we have Maltese, and our guest is Grace Davis. And on his own chair, we have a miniature poodle, and his partner is Pearl Warner. So welcome to both of you ladies. I think we'll talk to Grace first, because we've never had Maltese on the program before. Some breeds I'm still looking for, you know, they're few and far between, or they're not in the area, or I haven't located them yet, but we found Maltese for you. So first of all, Grace, where do these dogs come from?
These dogs they're really from England. They were bred down for the Queen of England.
Oh,
and
okay.
They used to wear them around their neck. They used to put them like this. And they used to sit and carry them over their suits.
Oh,
and
my word.
And that's where they like to be.
Really? Up around your neck like
Oh,
that?
Yes.
Oh,
they're most comfortable when they're close to you.
Like little babies.
Yes. Yes, I call them my babies.
Well, it's almost like a scarf.
Isn't yes.
It? Now they could probably use them in England because they're having snow there, right?
Oh, yes.
So that would be great scarves.
I think anybody have them in England right now would love to have them.
I guess so. So then how did they get to Malta? Isn't that what they're named for, the Isle of Malta? That's why they're called Maltese?
Yes.
Okay.
And they're very fragile when you get them small like this.
Okay. Okay.
Most breeders will not sell these little ones to people that have small children.
Okay.
Because their bones are real thin and small, so they'll be easy to break.
Sure, it's a tiny little dog.
Yes.
So, you know, people think, oh, well, you know, small dogs, and I have small children, or, you know, I have a three-year-old, and it's like, oh, my gosh, you don't want a dog like this for a three-year-old.
No.
All you need to do is have the child fall on them once, and you've
Absolutely.
Got a good dog.
Absolutely.
I think people don't really think this through. Why were these dogs bred just as companions?
Companions for the queens, yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
And now they're not the number one pets. I think they're down to around number 10.
Okay.
But mainly that is because they have the maintenance is so high to take care of them.
Well, sure, I would guess with the coat. And they have, now you have these guys trimmed down, especially the faces. You can see this little face here. By the way, she's wearing her Easter finery. It might not be Easter, but she's wearing her Easter finery, and we'll get into that later. But even with the face, you can see that the little whiskers are trimmed down and the ears, because these ears will go all the way down almost to the ground.
Yes, yes. And I'd have them longer in the summer,
uh-huh.
But in the winter I cut them like this because I'm busier in the winter than I am in the summer.
Right.
And it gets in the food, and it gets red, and it causes the knot a lot. So I cut the ears short, and I cut around their faces more. Yeah. And I cut the hair that when they walk, it will not drag on the ground.
Okay.
So they won't get ice and snow in it.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
they like to be outside.
Really?
Oh, yeah. They like to play in the snow.
My goodness, if you have more than half an inch, you lost them. I can imagine that they would be very difficult to see in the snow as well.
Well, yes, they only go to the patio.
Oh, okay.
They're
okay.
only on the patio.
Okay.
They don't go any further than that. And they're 3 years old, but they have never climbed steps in their life.
Oh, my word.
Because little dogs are noted for the knees in and out of place, you know. And mine were fine, and I rescued these.
Okay.
I rescued Paige and Sophia. This is Sophia and this is Paige. I rescued them, and because they were rescued, and I did take them to the doctor, and the doctor said they were fine. Mm-hmm. I just didn't want problems up the road.
Yeah.
Because I have a dog that had both knees operated on twice.
Oh, my goodness.
And that can be painful for them and very expensive.
Oh, it certainly can
so
be.
So I wanted to prevent that from these little ones.
Mm-hmm.
So I keep them, I carry them up the steps, I bring them down.
Okay.
And now they will go down in the yard mm-hmm. in the summertime, mm-hmm. but they don't go in the yard in the winter.
Oh, okay.
And by the way, they're very easy to train.
Are they really?
Yes. You show them something one time and they got it. They sleep with me And at the foot of my bed, I have a pee pad there. And when they don't wake me up at night. If they have to go to the bathroom at night, they go to the foot of my bed, and that's where they go.
Okay, okay.
And then they come back up. This one, a Sophia gets in my chest, I mean, under my rib cage, and she sleeps around my head.
Well, so you don't move very much at night.
No, I don't.
Right.
No.
You just lay there.
No, I just lay.
Even if you're not comfortable, you just lay.
I just lay, yes. I think my body has gotten accustomed to being in that one position,
that's exactly where they are.
That's
exactly right. When you were talking about the health problems, is that the only problem they have with the kneecaps?
Well, that's the main thing. A lot of them get, it's like a backwards cross that they get.
Okay, the reverse sneeze.
All little breeds
will
have that. Thank God, these don't.
Okay.
They don't have that. Now, Sophia have a little allergies.
Sometimes.
And I have to give her a little pill maybe 4 times a year.
What is it, like from the outside allergies, or is it a food allergy that
I don't know what it is, what causes it, because we didn't run the test on her.
Okay.
I just give her a quarter of a tablet, you know, and that takes care of it. And she might not have it again for 6 or 7 months.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Wow, that's great.
Yeah.
Now, you said they were rescues. You got these from a person who was a reputable breeder, but unfortunately was dying of cancer.
Yes. She had cancer, kidney cancer. And she had to find homes for her dogs because she knew that she wasn't going to make it. And I did give her a small fee. The mother of these little girls were bought from here, from Diane, Foxy Fur. So I knew that they were good dogs because they came from Diane.
Right.
And so when she was getting rid of them, Diane told me that she was going, and this one girl wanted these dogs. But when they came, they were so, they had gotten up fleas, and they weren't pretty to look at.
Yeah.
And the girl decided she didn't want them, so I said, hey, don't worry about it.
Mm-hmm.
I saw the face.
They have adorable
they are
faces.
So pretty. I said, how can anyone not want them?
Right.
So.
This weighs, what, about 2 pounds?
No, she's 3.
Oh, she's 3 pounds.
She's
3 pounds,
and this one is 3.5 pounds.
Oh, wow, the fat one.
Yeah. Yes, he's the fat one. Yeah.
Oh, jeez.
But they are just—they're loving.
Mm-hmm. Now, when they're shown, these guys, the hair is sort of this is long down into actually the whole top of the top knot here comes right down. They just
their top knots are pretty long.
Yeah,
but they usually put two knots on the side.
Two knots either over the eyes. Yeah. So if you ever see them. Like, supposedly, I guess the Yukonuba show was on this past weekend, and if you saw the Maltese, they had two knots, two hickeys here above the eyeball. I don't usually do that.
What I usually do is braid their hair back and put a perm paper on it and tie it so it doesn't get dust and dirt in it that I can't take it out and comb it easy.
Right. And you can't leave the bands in very long.
No. They come out when I go home.
Right. Yeah, because the bands get all tangled in the hair, and then you just rip the coat out.
No, when I get home tonight, that comes out.
Now, you, with grooming, these guys have to be brushed or combed, like, every day.
Well, no, I don't do it every day.
Oh, okay.
I do it every day in the summer when they get outside in the yard.
Okay.
But for the winter time, I do it, like, 3 times a week.
Oh, is that all?
No, that's all.
Wow.
Cut and Heal is a product that they use on horses to comb the manes to keep them from getting knotted.
Right.
Well, that's what I use on them.
Oh, okay.
And their hair does not mat like that.
Oh, wow.
Now,
okay.
Paigey will get matted because Cooley plays with her and he bites and spits on her and then it gets wet and then she'll get matted.
Uh-huh.
But Sophia never had knots.
Cooley is your other dog.
Yeah, Cooley is a standard poodle.
So you can have little dogs and big dogs together.
Oh, yeah.
Right?
Oh, yes. Cooley loves. I said, Cooley, these are your babies.
Yeah. Well, except Cooley's a boy.
Cooley's a boy. He doesn't know it though.
Nobody told him, huh?
Nobody told him he's a boy.
Now, these only come in one color, right?
Right. They're all white.
All white.
Yeah.
Do they come in the biscuit or is it just all white? Do they have
all white? Sometimes you'll find a little lemon.
Okay.
A little bit of lemon in their ears.
Okay. Okay.
But they are basically white.
Okay.
And if you want to know if you got a good breed, you look. And they have, you look at their paws, and they have their pads are black.
Okay.
And they have like eyeliner on.
Yes. That certainly brings out their face. Right, right. And the black nose.
And when you give them a bath, you should find some black spots on their body someplace.
Yeah, it's interesting, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
You know, that they're not pure white.
No.
Because the skin
had black spots on it.
Yes. Very interesting. Nature's amazing. I just think nature's amazing.
I know.
Now, you said they were easy to train. Are we talking about house training as well? Now, you do the outside. They go outside. But they also have the puppy pads.
And the house.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, a lot of times people with toy dogs don't. They're so small. I mean, 3 pounds. So they need to go out more frequently. Can you imagine the size of the bladder in this little guy? You know, the little girl, I'm sorry. But the bladder is so tiny, so they take 3 laps of water and they have to go and pee. Well, you know, if you're not giving them a place inside to do something like the puppy pads, they're going to go on the floor. And, you know, it's nobody's fault but your own. When you're looking at this type of dog, you got to think a little bit ahead. Well, with this type of, I always think she's going to jump off.
She won't.
She doesn't jump off, but no. It's still, you know, like a child. You want to grab it.
No, she will not jump.
Another thing with this type of dog or this size dog, like the Yorkies, most of the toy dogs, they really don't need very much exercise.
No, they don't.
They're like wind up bunnies. They're like the Energizer bunnies.
Right.
They race around the house, and that's where they get all their exercise.
That's where they get their exercise.
They like to go for walks.
But when I take them for walks, they're in a stroller.
Oh, geez.
Now,
that is not a walk.
No. When they go walking, they're in a stroller. But I must tell you, there are squirrels and rabbits and other dogs. And because they're so small,
yes.
I only give them what the state requires in shots.
Okay.
I don't give them any added shots or anything. So, therefore, I don't let them come in contact
with other dogs.
Or where rabbits and squirrels and all of that.
Yeah.
Because and they are small. And I know doctors tell you they should have it, but I don't believe that.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't believe little dogs should get all the shots that they say they should have.
Right. Well, you know, it's like your own child.
Yes.
You know, you listen to your doctor and then make your own decision.
Right.
You know,
and
it's the same with your dogs. If you don't feel that they should have them, you know, by all means.
And my dogs are healthy.
Yes.
I have not had a doctor bill in over a year for these little ones. Now, Cooley, I have to take once in a while because when he gets groomed, I don't groom him. I take him to get groomed.
Okay.
And sometimes he gets ear infections.
Okay.
And I have to do something, but now I've learned keep his ears cleaned out. When he comes home, I dry him out.
Mm-hmm.
Don't have that either.
Yep.
Well, you learn like you do with your children.
Right. Well, I have to talk to Pearl about that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Why did you select this breed of dog? Or did it select you?
No. I got impregnated in the mind
when I got
my first one. I wanted a dog.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted a little dog. I had Buttons, and Buttons had really... My husband had taken Buttons over, and I'm a nurturing person. I wanted something to nurture.
Okay. Buttons is another Maltese?
No, Buttons is a Pomeranian.
Oh, okay, okay.
And Buttons, I was talking to my groomer one day, and the girl that worked for her was a friend of Diane's.
Okay.
And they said, because I was looking at Shih Tzus, and they said, Grace, why would you want a Shih Tzu when you have a Maltese?
Mm-hmm.
And she gave me Diane's number.
Okay.
So I called Diane because I wanted to know what they looked like, and Diane didn't have any, but she said that she had a friend who was coming up from Georgia, and that she was going to bring the father, the mother, and 2 puppies, and that I could have one of the puppies if I put a deposit down. I says, nope, I don't buy paid in the bag, but I promise you, if I like it, I will buy it. So when she came with the dog, they were so beautiful. They were just so gorgeous. And I said, oh my goodness. I didn't know. I wanted to buy both of them. But she had promised one to a doctor in Philadelphia. So I count the kisses. And Abigail Elizabeth, that was her name, she gave me one kiss more. But she was a fluke bird. She was born with a hole in her heart.
Oh, no.
So she died before she was 2.
Oh, what a shame.
Yeah. And that's what caused me to get all these other ones, because I wanted to replace Abigail.
Yes.
Abigail was my child.
Yes, but you can't replace them.
No.
Each one is different.
I know.
Different.
I know, but this is the closest to Abigail.
Uh-huh.
But Abigail never got over a pound.
Oh, my. And, that was tiny.
Yeah.
Very tiny.
Yeah, and Buttons was the one that told me that Abigail was sick that morning.
Wow.
And I called the vet, Janet, and she left her house and she came down.
Wow.
And I couldn't function very well.
No.
But with that, I only had two dogs, and I have six.
You keep adding, right?
I have six. But in the meantime, that's when my husband was sick, too.
Oh, my word.
So I was taking care of him.
Yeah.
And I just wanted more and more dogs. And after I would get him to bed and get everything settled with him at night, I would sit and calm myself back home.
Oh, yes. I mean, they're a great relaxation.
Yeah.
You sit there, you hold the dog, and you pet it, and it's like, well, they know, studies have shown that your blood pressure decreases when you're petting a dog. So, you know, if you're stressed out, great thing to do is get a dog.
Yeah.
Touch. Right. That's exactly
right.
That's
all you need is just touch.
Plus the undying devotion.
Yes.
Nobody's as happy to see you as your dog.
I know. It's unconditional love.
Exactly right.
Wow.
Yep. No matter what you are or who you are, your dog always loves you. Well, let's talk to Pearl a little bit before we're out of time here and talk about her poodle.
Well, my poodle was trying to come over here and just say hello to the girl.
Yay.
You know, Humphrey Bogart wants to say hi to the Maltese.
Yeah.
He was huffing and puffing in here. It's warm underneath the lights here with all this coat.
Mm-hmm.
And with all that coat, you want to be able to keep it in under control.
Yeah, yeah.
So I don't know if you noticed all the colored purple.
Oh, yeah, the beads
we have in
the
hair.
Can you see that? Can we get the beads in his hair a little bit better?
It's rubber bands.
Oh, rubber band. Oh, okay. We can't.
There you go.
Yeah, they're all rubber banded. So
these two sections here are his ear.
Okay.
These sections up top here are part of his head hair, which we call the top knot.
Yeah.
And that's there.
No, why do you do that?
It's there for maintenance when they're not being shown.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Because if you don't put the rubber bands in here and section the hair, you just leave it like the body pack all the time, it's going to spin around, mat up when he lays down, rubs, rolls. It's going to mat up almost at the drop of a hat.
Okay, so it's twice the work then.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly. And you can't keep banding every part of the dog's body. But this, the part with the head and the ears, when you had the dog at the show in the show condition to be performing, all the bands are out. And it's all sprayed up. It is sprayed up.
Right.
But held in place with tiny rubber bands at the base of the skull.
Okay.
And then combed out and sprayed up. So it has a beautiful, beautiful poodle look.
Right. And then that little poof here, that little pompadour
that they have in front of the eye. And I did forget to bring the finished show picture along of the before and after.
Okay. Okay. Well, you all know what poodles look like, you know.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure you do.
With that big fluff and, you know.
Exactly.
And you don't, certainly, if you go to a show, you certainly don't want to pet that top knot if they're ready to go in the ring, because the handler will kill you.
Even though they're spraying, they will kill the owner. May you pet the dog, and if it's before they go in the ring, I'll say afterwards, you may pet them. The dog will appreciate that.
Mm-hmm.
No,
you
the
see,
owner will appreciate
it. Yeah.
He really wants to say hello to these girls here. And that's one of the good personalities of the poodle.
Yes, yes.
Very outgoing, very, very pleasant dogs. There's a lot of maintenance with the coat when you have a show dog.
Mm-hmm.
Now, with this dog individually here, he was at a show this weekend, and he did get winner's dog and best of opposite
set. Oh, very good.
Yeah. At the show down at Boardwalk.
Okay, okay.
In Wildwood, New Jersey.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's what we call, he's singled out in his points.
Okay.
So now his next adventure and ordeal is to find two majors, which is 3 points.
I mean, he's
had that twice.
Or more.
Or more. Oh, yeah, or
more.
I've already had a 5-point major in one of my poodles. But two of those 3-point majors would finish him then to his championship title.
Oh, very good.
Yeah.
Now,
so
his daddy is a foreign dog.
His dad is actually an import dog from Denmark. And his color is brown too.
Yeah.
But this is his product. This is his son.
And you can see
Why do they have those stupid pom-poms on the back end?
These here, it all goes back to,
don't that look dumb? Well, you know, people, maybe not for you, but to me it looks dumb.
Well, people would say, oh, what a nice French poodle you have there. But in all essence, they were born in Germany.
Yes.
But it was the people in France who really brought this dog to fame. Mm-hmm. They could go anywhere into the restaurants mm-hmm. in the foreign country. But
actually, this is a hunting dog.
For hunting. Yes. German, okay. Germany made them into hunting dogs. Yep. Water dogs, poodles,
yes.
Dogs.
Right.
So, for them, way back when, they, to get into the water and so they can facilitate their swimming and still not let them get cold, these pucks here on the hip protect the dogs at his joints.
Oh, all right. Okay.
And the same way with down in the leg at the hock area,
uh-huh.
it's the same thing. It protects the joints, and this protects the organs, the pack.
Okay, the heart, yeah, the heart, lungs. Okay.
Yeah, well, it makes
sense,
so
I guess. Mm-hmm. It still looks dumb, but I guess it makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
You know, well, why not at the knees? The knees are joints.
Well, it has it on the front. The knees are there. The knees are right in here.
Well, those are the ankles. I'm talking about the knees in the back.
They're there.
No, up higher. Up higher at the knees.
Oh, this knee.
That's the knee, not the ankle.
Well, there is a pattern that you can do.
Okay.
But to preference, most people like this because as a groomer, it's less work.
Uh-huh.
Less work.
Sure.
The other one has a length of fur covering itself all through here.
Okay.
A tiny little shave band, as you were saying. And it didn't come to mind right away what you were saying because that's not my favorite trim. And you're only allowed three particular trims in the poodles.
Uh-huh.
Only three trims.
Wow.
The one is fluffy all over as a puppy.
Right. Okay.
And when that one gets to be 1 year old, it got to go into this pattern, or hence the one you were talking about.
I don't remember what that one's called.
Yeah.
Pack.
It's English English saddle trim mm-hmm. and the Continental.
Okay.
And this is the Continental.
Well, Continental, of course.
The Continental.
And he's got to say hello to that little girl.
Oh, he just can't get... Yeah, that's on his mind.
Yeah, well, put him on your lap so we can see him.
Yeah.
There you go. Now, what kind of health problems do these have?
Well, to be quite honest with you, the miniature variety...
And you only have the minis, right?
Only the miniatures.
Okay.
To me, they're not too big. Standards are larger.
Mm-hmm.
Toys are smaller, so mm-hmm. I figure, well, he's not too small. It's
right.
My preference.
Okay.
Health issues can be varied immensely. Right now, as this stands, as of February in 2009, the miniatures are the healthiest variety.
Oh, wow. Okay.
This is the least amount of health testings that we do is on the miniatures.
Okay.
The standard poodles, which are the next size up,
mm-hmm.
Have some pretty many issues with the autoimmune system.
Okay.
Autoimmune, and then, of course...
Well, I think they have the skin that relates to the skin problems that they have as well. Isn't that what...
Well, that is...
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
That's how it manifests.
There's numerous, numerous things.
What about the eye problem?
Well, that was basically... that eye problem hit me 20 years ago.
Oh, my.
Just when they were beginning to... talk about this,
mm-hmm.
okay? And it took them 7 years later before they actually got a genetic marker on this.
Okay.
So now you can draw blood and test your dog immediately to find out if the dog is normal or clear or carrier.
Right.
And I've been very blessed knowing that.
Yeah,
knowing
that was just such a tragedy. But that's really something that they have genetic markers for an awful lot of diseases now.
Well, at least with the eye problem, your dog is not going to die from the eye problem. Whereas some of the autoimmune systems, they're very stressed.
Mm-hmm.
And as you had touched, Ms. Davies, on the veterinarian and stuff like that with the shots,
mm-hmm.
sometimes less is better for the dogs.
Yes, we all agree there.
Okay.
The veterinarians suggest it, recommend it, but they have to because of, lawsuits. So, they do what they need to do according to the law, but you have to make your own decision, one way or the other, what you want to do with your own dog, just like I said, with your own children. These guys are very easy to train.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I must brag.
Oh.
Okay. It goes back to his father, too. I can now say I am the proud breeder of two certified therapy dogs.
Oh, very good.
And also agility title dogs.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, so now that, other than just having pretty dogs to look at,
They have brains.
Yes.
So athletic.
So I'm really, really pleased about that.
Very good. Very good. They require a fair amount of exercise, though.
Yeah, they do.
Okay.
They do.
So this is not, I mean, if you're going to keep an, and they're great apartment dogs, and they're great for older people, but you're going to have to get out there and walk, you know.
Yeah.
It's not a dog that you can just leave in the house and say, oh, well, you know, the dog will get the exercise like the Maltese inside. No, they're, unless you want your house ripped up, and you're not going to.
Because they are very intelligent, too, it's.
They need a job.
I use the philosophy, you know, is their mentality is things to do.
Yes.
Places to go.
Right. And if they don't have an outlet for that, they're going to make their own. I mean, if you don't have a job for them, they're going to make their own. And unfortunately, it may not be what you want, like ripping up the cushions or, you know, little things like that. So.
And another great thing, you know, this is a lot of work for a show dog. Tremendous amount of work, a lot of dedication. But this is something in my career that I have done, and I love to do this. But the blessing is for the average person, the pet person, don't have to have a dog in this coat.
Right. Yeah.
The poodle is so acceptable to almost any style that you can think of in a haircut, and it's wonderful. It's acceptable.
Right.
But I use an example. If you would have a schnauzer, the silver dogs, sporting dogs, that long, long beard and eyebrows. Can you imagine what it would look like if you take the beard off?
Oh yeah. Right. At least with these guys, you can have the beard or not.
What is that? But as an example, you know, poodles, you can trim them any which way you like.
That's exactly right.
It's fun.
And you still recognize what it is.
Yes, that's fun. Hurry up and finish so I can cut the hair down.
And they come in many colors.
Many colors.
Right.
Yes.
Right. So you don't really have to get a white one. You can get
a
brown one.
The black ones, the white ones, the brown ones, the silver ones, the apricots, the red ones, ones that we call blue, which aren't really quite a true, true black.
Okay. And they also have the ones that are two colors.
Party colors.
Okay.
Yes. Yes.
Are those acceptable? Or
believe it or not, it's not acceptable in the show ring of the confirmation.
Okay.
But AKC, I mean, Poodle Club of America has accepted them in all their events.
Okay.
That they have.
The performance
Performance events.
Okay. So that's
that
agility,
is acceptable.
Obedience. Okay.
Exactly.
Okay. But
exactly.
It is like a mismark. It should not. Okay. It's like a Dalmatian with a big black eye.
They prefer them to be solid.
Solid colors. Right.
Yes.
Okay. And why did you pick this breed?
When I was maybe around 17, I just happened to see a picture, and I thought, wow, that was a different dog.
Yeah.
And then my sister had gotten one from my parents,
a
little white one.
Uh-huh.
He didn't live long, though.
No.
He didn't live long, and he had an eye condition.
Mm-hmm.
But after that, you fell in love with that dog, so it just passed on.
Yeah, of course.
It rubbed off.
I don't want to cut you off, but we're running out of time, and I just wanted to let you know that the little dresses that this dog is wearing, the Easter finery that the Maltese are wearing, Grace is the one who makes dog clothes. She makes all her outfits. She makes and sells outfits for dogs. So if you have a little dog that you'd like to wear a dress, or, you know, my breed, it'll look pretty stupid, but if you want little dresses or little coats or little booties or pajamas, she was telling me she makes pajamas for, like, the Chinese crested who don't have any hair, for them to be, you know, at night. So anyhow, I wanted to let you know that Grace does make dog clothing. So that's our program for this evening, and I thank you very much for joining us. Good night.
Dogs on VCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.